here is waiting at stage because I thought they were coming out that way. I'm like, I need to know. Hey, my name is Christine Khan, and along with Mr. Red Sickle, we would like to bid you welcome to tonight's auditory feast. We're going to go left to sketch because we've got a different style coming out on stage. First, we're also going to start with a piece, Old Roots. It's going to start with some chimes and some bells. What do you think this song's going to sound like? Start with bells. Being called Oranges and Lemons. I don't know the other way. Just want to let you experience it. I'm excited to bring these young ladies out here. So, here we go, Oranges and Lemons. support getting these singers here. Because I know sometimes it's not easy. And sometimes people have to move variable mountains to show up, and to be present, and to do something scary, and to put themselves out there. So I just wanted to say how proud I am of you. Super proud, so much, that I'm getting even started and I'm going to peace out off stage. Because they worked so hard, they don't need me anymore, which is every teacher's dream for them to be able to do that now. Please, thank you.
Thank you. Spark of light, far wide. saw earlier, the Oranges and Lemons, both written and arranged by Paul Ayres, who is a British London-based composer, and he, as it turns out, is going to be visiting Abington High School in April as a part of a grant that we received the Abington Education Foundation. So we're really thankful to the AEF for sponsoring that, for granting that money so we can have that experience. He's going to come and talk about composition. Just want to make that plug before this next thing. Hi, everybody.
Hi.
I can see you now.
Hi, Mr.
Kira, I'm excited you're going to help us with this too. We're all going to get a chance to look just a little bit silly.
They did pretty good at it.
Yeah. I want you to tell your neighbors right now that they're going to be awesome at this next thing. You tell them right now. So, you saw the varsity bass choir do a little fruit salad dance. We're all going to learn this together with the help of the choir and Mr. Nick Towles at the piano.
Okay.
Yeah.
Can you stand there? Why are you? or make her own fruit salad. Yeah. At the end, all of this, they're at just like the last time, and then you just sing, yum. Okay, there we go. Brace yourselves. This is going to be great.
Paula's sitting with her row here. She speaks Spanish. We're going to sing some Spanish. We're still learning Spanish. We've got it down pretty good. It'll be great. Thank you. I need support. They need support because about three or four rehearsals ago, they're like, we should sing this song, but we should move. So we watched some YouTube videos. Like, these dances. We could try that. We kept trying it. And it's really fun, but makes it hard. They've been doing great. I don't know how to dance this. That's their problem. So I'll just sort of do here. It's a little hard work. But I want to give one little understanding because I didn't realize this until we went a little deeper into the text here. It's another folk song. It's a Colombian folk song. And it's not deep. But the movements that this video that we watched did were a little bit music. I didn't realize that because I wasn't really looking at the text. The text is pretty simple. It's basically about a guy who's a baker. He's a baker and he sells his bread, his stuff, for credit. He doesn't always get the money, so he's very giving to the things he makes. And his wife is not so happy about this. You can guess, it's an unfortunate sort of macabre. The wife leaves town and the macabre that he's not dead, the wife finds another friend. It's really not that great sort of thing. And macabre, the lesson learned for him, he's like, I just want to sell the credit again. That's fine. That's the lesson he took for this. That's the backstory. All the fun stuff happens, that's not what we're thinking about. But some of the moves are like macabre and making the bread. And there's one word. Sweating. So you're going to see them sweating a lot through the making of all this bread. That's the story. Yay! So this is my good thing.
Yeah. Thank you. the beautiful luxury of having two, well, more than that, but I guess I should say two higher adult musicians on this concert, one of which you just saw leave the stage for the first time, so a shout out before he runs too far. This is a big applause for Nick, who's playing the piano for us. They are students, junior, correct?
Yes.
Clarinet and environmental studies? Environmental science major. What a clear combo. So, thank you very much. I'm thrilled at this conclusion, but I'll warn you in advance, you've never seen anything like it, or heard anything like it. And I want to make a highlight of this moment before we sing our last number. That the joy of doing this in a school, as if I get to come to school every day with Christina and just like make music with a beautiful bunch of humans, what a gift. And it is not by accident. The school, the district, I'm very happy that the support is here to create spaces for this to happen. And I don't want to leave this space without saying it has to continue. It must continue for the sake of these people, for all of us, and for, let's just be honest, the world. Without the music, the creativity, the arts, we won't have ways to express that which we need to get out. And we need to say this. So thank you. So any ways you can support the arts, being there being the most important, being there with your kids, your family, that is so critical. But being a consumer of this beautiful artwork. So thank you. What I wanted to say is that it ranges from the sublime of the past song to perhaps the ridiculous. So we leave you tonight with an ode to the most forgotten vegetables, the rutabaga. Thank you. that is dessert.
So I'm going to ask you to stick around, enjoy some time with everyone here out in the lobby. Thank you for bringing all those desserts. It's been a pleasure. On behalf of Christina Kahn, thank you wherever she is back there. Thank you for being here. Stay calm and have a wonderful spring.